Hi, welcome to Heartfleet Creating. Today I want to talk about resin and alcohol inks and the Petri dish effect. It's not really a tutorial, more of a sharing what I learn, as well as hoping to inspire you to experiment and try if you haven't done so already. And if you have, I would love to hear from you, so please comment below. You can also check out the heartfleetcreating.blogspot.com blog that goes along with much of the most of the videos that are on this channel. You do need alcohol inks, and a key ingredient, I use the Pinata White Blanco Blanco ink. You need something that's heavier that actually pushes the clear ink into the resin. So you need epoxy resin, not UV resin. Already I can tell you that I did try UV resin and the Petri dish effect, and it didn't work. I'm guessing because it was just, I don't know, maybe because of the ultraviolet light, probably not getting through the opaque resin. The opaque ink, which is the white ink. You can experiment if you want, of course. I didn't try using a transparent mold and then shining the light from below or flipping it over. That might have helped cure it. All I know is I used a really beautiful faceted pendant mold made of silicone, and thought, oh, this is going to be really cool, because it worked with the epoxy resin in the exact same mold that you'll see later on. And when I went to unmold it, it was a gooey mess in the middle. So where the UV resin and the alcohol ink was sitting, it just couldn't cure. And I tried flipping it. Yeah, so I just use epoxy resin for the Petri dish effect. It works the best. And another thing, I've been using art resin for my epoxy resin. I really like it. However, it's definitely, if you want strength in a cast piece, that means something that is like a solid mold. Like these hearts that I did, they're not very big, so they're solid. However, I did some coasters, about a coaster shape, coaster size, maybe 5x5. And it actually, even weeks later, the art resin is not hardening rock hard like many resins. I thought all epoxy resin cured to a very hard plastic, hard resin. But actually, art resin doesn't. So apparently, as I'm learning about resins, some resins are created for different purposes, like doming, casting, putting a coating on fine artwork. Like there's some beautiful alcohol ink paintings out there that are being done on a hard substrate and then coated or domed with art resin. Art resin, I highly recommend it for what I'm using it for. It's working great. So just don't let your resin sit very long once you have it mixed. Get out your air bubbles if you want. Actually, I lied. I didn't actually get out my air bubbles. I just started dropping ink. So here's some molds that I used, trying to give you a close-up from a side view so you can see that Petri dish effect. For anyone who doesn't know what a Petri dish is, it's just a little disc clear container used in science where they put swatches or swabs of things and then they let things grow. And it's mold. Actually, if you look at this, it reminds me of mold. And you think of, some people love growing mold because it's just a really cool effect. It's alive and active. And I think the most fun part of all, actually, when using the Petri dish effect, is watching the white ink with the other inks as you layer them one over another, back and forth, back and forth, is you can see it moving and bubbling like it is alive. So it's really cool. And something that I just tweaked my memory as I saw the silicone bead mold pass by, do not. I have ruined already enough silicone molds trying to, you know how you want to get the bubbles out, and I bought a little butane torch, which is great. It's really cool having all that power in your hand, but with great power comes great responsibility, something from Spider-Man. With a torch, you got to be careful, because it actually melted my silicone molds just enough that it melted the resin, and then I had to rip it out. It tore the mold. It wrecked the piece. So for delicate silicone molds, do not use the butane torch. Use a heat gun or the traditional, that I first learned from Nerdy Crafter, Jackie at Nerdy Crafter a long time ago, just to use like a lighter or one of those barbecue lighters that are a little with a longer stick, kind of stick lighter, so you don't burn your fingers when you're tipping it upside down trying to get the bubbles up. And again, just flash the heat by to get bubbles up. But because of the Petri dish effect, it's all about being bubbly and alive and watching things happen and it being random and organic. So I wouldn't really worry about bubbles for this particular technique because you're not going to notice anyway. Now, I just like this one that it's passing by right now is one of the only pieces that actually ended up looking like Jasper stone. And I thought that was pretty cool. But all the rest have a very similar look just because of the technique that I used, which was random. I never started with the white first. I always started with just the random, like alcohol, ink, Adirondack, and pinata, keeping in mind that pinata is a much more intense ink pigment. Some of the Adirondack ones or Ranger, they can be, but pinata, all of them are. So a little goes a long way. And I don't know, it's just so much fun. So you just layer the white ink and then the colored and white and colored and move it around randomly. You could take a toothpick if you want and swirl it, but I didn't. You can see the micro bubbles in my pieces. So again, if that matters to you, torch out your bubbles. No, sorry. Depending what mold they're in, get rid of your bubbles however you so choose. A straw apparently works. I tried that way back. Again, I learned that from Nerdy Crafter Jackie, but it didn't work for me. I couldn't do it. In fact, I ended up probably with more drool potential in my resin when you're blowing into a straw, that condensation. And the straw, again, got some, condensation, drool, whatever you want to call it. So for me, straw, using a straw did not get the bubbles out. And this was a chocolate mold. Again, you'll have learned if you watched the previous video that UV resin doesn't work well in dark molds. If you have, unless you're just using a simple dye and the UV light can get right through. But with the Petri dish effect, you're not going to worry about that. So you can totally use all the opaque solid molds, silicone molds that you want, because the beauty of epoxy resin, which I tend to love the most, even though it does take time to stir, to cure, 24 hours and all of that, it's worth it because you're not ever disappointed by when you're demolding things and you end up with a gooey mess on the other side of that piece, which has happened to me multiple times. I've even thrown out good molds out of utter frustration because the UV resin just didn't cure. So epoxy resin is great. You won't be disappointed. So I don't know if you've noticed, but as I'm showing all the pieces that I worked on, the wrong side is usually ends up more of a solid effect depending on the size of the mold that you're using. But some people, there's some really good channels out there doing the Petri dish effect. So definitely check out the actual how-to process. I spared you from that because this video is long enough. But and some people actually like the other side. Oh, and here's another beautiful faceted pendant mold. The one, it's small, but I did use it and I got some really beautiful ones. This one, I left the epoxy resin and just used a little bit of ink to have a more minimal effect, but see how it's still pooled in the back, and then I filed it down. And then this other piece, I really love it. It was more of a, turned out kind of ended up with a salmon pink look, but there's just something really addictive about doing the Petri dish effect. And again, in this crystally looking one, it does have the micro bubbles, but it just adds to the character and it doesn't matter to me. And I don't want to wreck this mold with my torch. Now, there are different techniques. Some people I see like to drop their inks in random patterns, which is what I did with no rhyme or reason. Some people like to try making pictures by putting them more symmetrical. It's totally up to you. So I just hope that by sharing these videos and any lessons that I've learned thus far in my resin experience, as well as my alcohol ink. Oh man, God love alcohol inks. There's so many things you could do with them. So you could end up with so many different cool effects. I do plan on turning most of my pendants or my pieces into pendants to sell in my abergycreation.etsy.com Etsy shop. So you're under no obligation, of course, to go check it out. Just want to share that for anyone who might be interested. And I love this mold. Again, most of my molds, actually pretty much all of them, I got on ebay.ca. Check out the corresponding blog for any links in that. I try to share those as much as I can at heartfullycreating.blogspot.com. So thanks for stopping by. I would love to hear from you if you decided to try this, or if you have any questions, ideas, thoughts, any advice would be appreciated. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you want to. And have a great weekend creating.